Now, Heritage Foundation senior writer Kelsey Bolar. Kelsey, you know, of course, AOC has had this battle with Jeff Bezos ever since she played a major role in Amazon abandoning New York City. Is there any sort of truth in what she's saying with respect to Amazon?
Absolutely not. This was really irresponsible on her part because she knows Amazon raised its wages to $15 an hour plus benefits, and yet she went on national TV and suggested otherwise, worse than otherwise. She suggested that Amazon is paying its employees starvation wages, which is really interesting coming from the congresswoman who is at the federal level advocating for a $15 mandatory minimum wage. So unless she's advocating for minimum wage that she considers to be starvation wages, you know, this is completely misguided. Not to mention, she drove out some 25,000 jobs from her district, where you know, that people would have who lost out the opportunity to have those jobs are actually making starvation wages because they're not making any money.
Well, you know, I checked in the most recent figures for the Bronx is $37,000 a year with 28% in poverty. So, you know, I think any jobs there would be welcome for sure. But by the same token, you know, you hit on it. $15 has been met. That was the threat for many years among progressives. So Amazon more or less said, OK, we'll do it. And now you've got to do health care. You got to do free college. And there are a few other things, a few other hurdles have been placed there. Have some of these corporations actually opened the door to be hijacked more by these kind of stuff?
I think they've certainly run the risk of doing that. I think there's a balance to be found. We want Amazon and other large companies to be increasing their wages for workers when they are growing enough to be able to do that. So I applaud Amazon for raising its wages to $15, and I support more businesses doing that. That said, 70% of businesses in the United States are small businesses, and they do not have the ability to just across the board overnight raise their wages to $15 an hour, and to ask that of them from the federal level would be incredibly harmful and actually cost people jobs.
Real quick, speaking of pushing and elbowing and getting your way, progressives are pushing harder and harder against Nancy Pelosi. AOC leading the charge there, taking on President Trump in a series of tweets also today. Are we getting closer to the Dems going for some form of impeachment?
You know, at some point you'd like them to put their money where their mouth is, because they keep talking about impeachment and yet they won't actually take the steps to go there. And that's because they know it is not popular among Americans, and it's not even popular among their own base. It's only popular among the more radical members of their base who might support figures like Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez. So I think they're just trying to drum up a lot of media attention to make it act like they're doing something, but they have not actually taken those steps to get there.
Kelsey, thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you.